What is the importance of the psychological or the mental health? First aid. We all aware about the first aid, when to give, why to give. For the physically sick or the people who are in a trauma or in an accident. But when we talk about the psychological first aid, when we are supposed to give that? And why it is necessary? Do we have the enough personnel, professionals to give the mental health awareness or in the first aid? So we have lots of questions to ask, and we have the few couples of people, we can say, to answer about this. Okay, so just to proceed in that, first one, I just want to say that the person who are mentally ill, we all know that they are stigmatized. What is stigma? What is stigma? Why do we label them? Recently, the outbreak of the chikungunya and dengue in Delhi, no one has talked, the people said that the person has suffered from the chikungunya. We don't label them, right? But the people or the person who is suffering from the mental health or the mentally ill, once they come to the hospital, when the neighbors come to know about that, they'll be labeled as a mentally ill. So this prevents them from what? This prevents these people from coming up to that, especially to the professionals to seek the help. Okay? And they will be discriminating from the society. How many of us, even though we are the health professionals, how many of us we accepted mentally ill people to be around you? We have come across many people in our locality, in our street. Do you treat them properly? Are we really aware about them? No. Even though we have the knowledge about the mental health, how to take care of that, what is a mental illness, we still don't. We still discriminate them from their rights, from their birthrights. Okay? So this one, especially when we work in the community, even in that workplace, the people who are suffering from the mentally ill. So people are aware, people come to know that he has been stigmatized, he has been labeled as a mentally sick. So people just make the discrimination, even though he has a good productivity capacity in his workplace, still the people has a negative impact or the negative thinking about him. Okay? So same wise life in that healthcare also, when the people don't come up to seek the professional health or the professional help from the known personals, why they have been disturbing to come across, who's blocking in their way? We are people who are in the community. Even though we are aware about that, we don't know how to promote them, how to make the people aware about the mental illness. Right? So same thing, even in that community also, how many people knows about the community? Nobody talks openly about the mental health. Even in the mentally ill patient, nobody wants to say that one of our known person is suffering from the mental health. Why? They have a fear. People will discriminate us. They will not allow us to involve in any of the social function. So they don't come up. They just keep the person locked inside the house. They don't allow the family members to talk along with them, even to the community. This is the situation which is occurring in our society right now. But it's a time. We need to change this thought. We need to change the attitude of the people towards the mental illness. Other people who are mentally sick. And now coming to that, I just want to share something regarding that global scenario. When we talk about the mentally ill, every one of the four people are suffering from the any kind of the mental disorders. Either it may be depression, schizophrenia, anxiety, somatoform, any one or the other disorder of the mentally ill. And over the 400 million people in the worldwide are suffering from the mental disorders. And disorders, this is the one leading, that is the fourth leading cause in the cause of the global disease burden. As we all aware that WHO has given that for each disorder, they have the burden. They have calculated about the burden, so how much it's affecting in the society toward the political, economic growth in that. Right now, mentally ill on the mental illness is in the fourth leading cause. But by the year end of the 2020, there will be the expectation that it will become the second place under ischemic heart disease. There's no doubt in that because of the stressful situation in the life now. And now, we don't say the treatments are not available. Treatments are available, but still, people are not coming up. So why only the, even the two-thirds of the people who are suffering from the mental disorder, they don't come up to take the treatment? Because stigma, as I said, discrimination, again, and neglect. That's why I say that even the family members, when you go to the clinicals, you will come to know that parents will be complaining. उसको कोई problem नहीं है. 10 दिन पहले वो बिल्कुल ठीक था. अभी कुछ काम करना नहीं है उसने. इसलिए ये नाटक कर रहा है. काम नहीं करना चाहता ये. काम चोर हो गया ये अभी. This is the most common complaint you will hear from the parents or the relatives who comes to the clinical area. So why they say so? If they know about the mental disorder, they never say like that. They are all the family members, they are the loved one. Why they should say this? Okay? So because of this, sometimes they don't take the people to the hospital. उसको कुछ हुआ ही नहीं है तो hospital क्यों लेके जाओ उसको? Right? So these attitudes are there. This attitude we need to change. And along with this, in Indian scenario, we can say that India is also not less. Okay? So Indian epidemiological study in the recently, they find out that from the 9.5 to 370 persons per 1,000 population, it's suffering with the psychiatric disorders. And 20% of the adult mostly, they are affected with one or the other psychiatric disorders. And the 1 lakh people, suicide is the most sensitive coming up, we can say, issues. Okay, so in the every year, at least nearly 1 lakh people are finishing or ending their life with a preventable death, that is suicide. Okay, so in the, according to ICMR, recent study reports, they say that in the Delhi NCR itself, 8 to 10% of the people, they will suffer from any psychiatric disorders like depression, anxiety and schizophrenia, which is very common among the populations. Then, now coming to the dignity and respect. Do we really respect the people who are suffering from mentally ill? How do we show the respect to them? And what is this dignity? See, dignity is like you have to treat the other person like a human being. I'm not saying that we don't treat them as a human being. We treat them. But how we're treating with the normal people is different. Okay, but in the human, like in the dignity, as we said, the human dignity. For example, like physical care and respect for the individual. Just take an example of that person or the family who is having the person with a mentally ill. When I say that, why the person has been locked inside the room? Why he has not been allowed to talk with the other people? Why he has not been given the proper care at home? Whether though you are giving respect to that person? No. And coming to the self-dignity, that is the internal. You should make the persons to empower regarding their illness. They should make them aware about that, even though there will be the lots of changes in their behavior, okay, behavior changes because of the signs and symptoms of the disorder, still, you should make the people to empower about that. And how do we treat in our university, like in the society? Sometimes when you go and come across the street, one person who is mentally ill, people will start throwing the stone, cracking the jokes towards him. Nobody gives the respect to them. Why? And now, if you want to show the respect that there are other factors, if you give the right to the persons, they also have the rights. It's not like they are mentally ill, so all the rights can be exploited. It's not like that. Okay? When you give the right of that person, you allow the freedom of that person if it is not injurious to the self and the society. Okay? And when you give the personal space of that individual, and when you give the values, every individual has a values. We have to respect that values and we have to give the potential capability of that individual. It's not like the person is suffering from the mental illness, tum just baithe raho, tum kuch kaam mat karo, we'll do for you. Why? He has a capacity, he is not physically sick. He can do all the activities. So let him do. Let him participate in that activities, at least for his personal thing, for personal hygiene. But in our society, what is? He is suffering from the mental illness. Don't let him do anything. Okay? So that attitude has to be changed. So when you do all the this habits, value, capability of the person, then you can say you respect these people. And second one is like, as we all know, how the WHO has defined the health. And I don't need to go so detailed, so I'll just go to the mental health. Some of the students who are studying the third year may be knowing, but other students may not have much idea about that. So I'll just go through that, how the WHO has defined a person with a mentally health, or a mentally healthy. The person who can do his own decision, the person who can help the other people, who can establish a lovely environment or a relationship with the other people, and who can accept the strength and the weakness of that individual. And the person is independent, and the person is self-actualization, both intellectually and emotionally. Then you can say the person is mentally health or mentally healthy. And the people who are much in the contrast and out of track of this characteristics, we can call it as a person who is suffering from mentally ill. Okay. And the next one is like, here comes the main topic, psychological first aid and mental health first aid. As we all know that what is first aid? These are the services which is available immediately after any accident or any incident or injury, just to prevent the further harm and to promote the health of the people. Likewise, in the psychological first aid, what we say is, it is a human, supportive and practical assistance which will be given to any fellow who are in that need of crisis. So what is crisis now? In our daily life, the stressful situations, we are in some other way, we are in crisis. We cannot meet the deadline, okay? We cannot complete some task, it gives anxiety. Why? You have not finished your deadline and you are in the stress. But in the psychological first aid, as we said, it is a human, because we should treat a person as a human being as a whole. As a humanitarian principles, you will be dealing with that person, okay? And we should be supportive. How can you give the support to the person? You can allow the person to express the feeling of that person. What are the resources available? You've been talking about that. And it is a practical assistant. You just don't sit and talk. You have to do something like which is available. You can do this, you can do this. Or you make the person to allow to do it. Okay? So that is a psychological first aid given by WHO. Now coming to the mental health first aid. The same likewise, the assistance or the care which you will be given to the people who are diagnosed with a mental health. Okay? And the people who are taking the treatment of the mental health, or the people who are in the chronic stage of the mental health. This help or the assistance you will be giving till the time where is that appropriate professional assistance are available. I'll just take an example. One person has come to you and they started telling you, I just don't want to leave anymore. I feel like ending my life. There's no value for me in this society. So what you're supposed to do at that time? When the student comes and tell you, or somebody close to you and come and tell you, that they feel that you are the one who is trustworthy and you can help it out. So they're coming to you. But it's your responsibility now what you're supposed to do. We just cannot share with some of our friends that, okay, that people came and they were saying that they were saying all this thing. What should I do now? And here comes the matter of the confidentiality. As we all know that we say the matters of the students or the matters of our patients will not be sharing. Confidentiality should be maintained. But when you talk in the mental health, sometimes confidentiality doesn't work. I'm not saying all the time, but sometimes the confidentiality doesn't work. You need to think, you need to discuss with a health team member how to save the life of that individual. That is the most priority for you. Confidentiality comes in the second. Saving life, preventing from the harming in the future, that is in priority for you as a healthcare professional. Okay? So this is regarding the mental health first aid. So now, as I said, so there is some concept. When you give the mental health, what are the things should come in there? As I told you, it should be very supportive and practical. Practical in the sense like when you say to the people about that, you should feel that it should can be doable. It's not like only lecture they can show those. So कुछ नहीं होने वाला है, लेक्चर देखें तो कुछ करा लो पेशेंट को, या यू हैव टू डू समथिंग फॉर योर पेशेंट, दैट इज अ प्रैक्टिकल, एंड यू शुड बी वेरी सपोर्टिव टू दैट, एंड यू शुड गिव द अटेंशन टू द सोशल कंसर्न. इट्स नॉट नेसेसरीली दैट यू आर गिविंग सम हेल्प टू द पीपल. When you go to some other new place, first you have to see what is the social and what is the culturally acceptable way of giving help to the people. Okay? And that, as I said, it is a humanitarian approach. Why we give a psychological first aid? First one is safety. As I told you, saving the life of the person, the people who are harming to the self or the interest to others, you need to save the safety first. Second one is calm. When you give that psychological first aid, you should not be in hurry. You should be given the supportive care or the supportive psychotherapy in a very calm environment. And it should be connected. First, before you have to prepare yourself, where are the services available? And what you are supposed to do, what you are supposed to tell to the people whom you are helping. Okay, so you feel that, okay, this is still here, this is my work. Now you will be referring that individual to the health professionals or the mental health professional or the psychiatrist. So now you should know that if I say this to the one psychiatrist, if I talk, okay, one patient of this will be coming to meet you, please help me down. So this is the connectivity you have to show. And you have to show the way where the people have to go. Okay? And the self-efficacy, as I said, you make the person to do all these activities. You make the person to do independent. To be independent and do all his daily works by himself. And last one is hope. We cannot just say that okay, tumhare se kuch ho nahi sakta, tumhare saath ye sab ho gaya na to kuch ho nahi sakta. You are not supposed to say like that. Instillation of hope is very important factor when you give the psychological first aid. Okay? So as I told now, what are the goals of the psychological first aid or the mental health first aid? First, preserving the, this is the four A's. First one is preserving the life. Second one is you have to provide a help to prevent the mental health problem from becoming more serious. For example, if you don't recognize the symptoms in the early hours or the early symptoms, then what will happen? It will may become more severe. So the recovery rate or the prognosis of the mentally ill patient also, it is good when you identify in the early stages. And provide a comfort to a person with a mental health problem. How can you comfort them? Most of the time when you go to the clinicals, patient will be saying, मुझे आवाज़ें सुनाई देते हैं, मेरे सामने देखो वो लोग बैठ के ना मेरे सामने बात कर रहे हैं, वो लोग मुझे मारने का ना प्लानिंग चल रहा है, मैं अब क्या करूँ, मुझे यहाँ नहीं रह सकता, आई वॉन्ट टू गेट आउट ऑफ दिस वॉर्ड एंड रन अवे, आई डोंट फील लाइक स्टेइंग हियर. सो व्हाट यू आर सपोज टू डू, हाउ यू विल मेक द पर्सन टू फील कम्फर्टेबल इन दैट वॉर्ड, हाउ यू विल ब्रिंग द पर्सन to be in the reality, it's your responsibility, being a healthcare professional, okay? And promote the recovery of the good mental health, as I told you, how you can promote the health of the people who are suffering with a mental health. And who are the vulnerable groups or the people, as we all know, adolescent age group, okay? Because in this one, decision making, role confusion, okay? And that academic achievements, they all have the lots of risk factors in their life. So the adolescents are more prone, and even for the children like separated, other child abusers in the family, broken family, disorganized family, the children from these areas are more prone for the mental illness. And people who are with that any physical and mental disability, elderly people, pregnant women, and severe mental illness, divorcee and the widows, okay? And the people who are with the discrimination or the violence. And in this, there are many factors which will be contributing to the causes of the mental illness. For example, as we all know that biopsychosocial factors are the etiology of mental illness. So the biological causes may be hereditary, social causes, there are many factors. Okay, now again in the psychological factors also. And why we have to take this mental health first aid? Why, what is the reason behind it? First one is, mental health problems are very common. As I give you the scenario in the world and even in India, many people are suffering one or the other form of the mental disorders. But people don't come up and say, I have this problem, I have that problem. But this problem are very common among the people. So many people may not be available to give the help to the people. So we need to provide a mental health first aid. And people are not well informed that, see, why they are giving, you might have seen, that patient has got that hallucination, they have got that delusion, and they keep on going to the religious, ye mandir, wo mandir, wo baba, yahan pe baba hai, wahan pe baba hai. So by the time when they travel to all the babas and come back to the hospital, it will be too late. Okay? So in spite of, you can say the wasting the time in traveling all the mandis, babas and all, you just directly can say that if you find out that these people are having the signs and symptoms of mental disorder, directly ask them to go and refer and just meet some mental health professionals in the hospitals. Okay? Because as we said that the preventable and the curable properties of the mental illness are very high when you identify the problems in the early stages. And people with mental health problems, they don't have the adequate treatment. As I said, they take very treatment very late. And again, stigma and discrimination comes into picture. If I go to mental hospital, what people think about me? Mere bete se to koi shaadi nahi karega, hai na? So now, recently I've come across one case that the father was not ready to accept. He was not ready to accept that he is having that mentally ill. No, mere beta to itna acha tha, para itna acha se karte the. All over India, means 7 out of the only 7 posts were there. He came in the number 1, he got the job. And how you can say that my son is having this problem? Nobody is ready to accept that. Nobody is willing. What is the expectation? He's a bachelor, he just got a government job. Who is a parent who is going to accept that? Nobody will accept. That spends us a long time along with their children. They're expecting that at least one day he'll be earning good, right? But sometimes it doesn't happen. So the acceptability, that is also one issue in the mental health. And they may not have the insight. See, recently when you talk with the patients in the mental health or the mentally ill in the ward, first question hum kyun poochte hain? What question do you ask in the first? Aap yahan pe kyun aaye ho? Poochte hain na? Poochte ho kya third year students? Second year poochte hain? Poochte ho na?
Yes.
To patient kya jawab dete hain? पेशेंट क्या जवाब देते हैं? मेरा तो कोई प्रॉब्लम है ही नहीं, जबरदस्ती मैंने यहाँ पे देखा है, एडमिशन किया गया है. सो नाउ व्हाट इज योर पर्सपेक्टिव इन दैट? डू यू थिंक दैट पेशेंट हैज गॉट इनसाइट? नो, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम नॉट रेडी टू टेक. आई डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम, देन व्हाई शुड आई टेक द ट्रीटमेंट? राइट? अंटिल एंड अनलेस यू नो दैट यू आर सफरिंग. Some of the people are there, you know that you are suffering, still people don't take the treatment. But these people, they are not aware that they are suffering. They have the mental illness. Then why they should take the medication? So what is the side effect or the impact is, if you don't take the treatment, symptoms will not be curable. You will not maintain the symptoms. It will keep on worsening. So in all the side in the mentally ill patient, it's all the contradictory. Whether how to give the medication, how the person will allow that, or how you make them understand that they are suffering from the mental illness. Okay? And as I told you that in India, psychiatrists, or you can say that mental health professionals are around nearly 4,000 only. And we all know what is the population of India. Okay? So in this, what happened is, even though whenever we want and whenever we feel like seeking the help from the professionals or the experts, they will not be available. You might have seen in the wards, how many psychiatrists come and talk with the patient for a long time? How many of the nurses are talking in that ward for a longer time? Nobody. Everyone is quite busy, especially for the psychiatrist. More than 100 patients are waiting for him in the OPD. They'll just go for a rounds and come back, right? So it will be the nurses who will be going work or who will be working and who will be the recent contact for a longer time in that ward. You are the one who is going to identify the problem of the people around you. Okay? So this is your responsibility. And why we have to take them is, psychological first aid or the mental health first aid is found to be the very effective to reduce the discrimination and the stigma to find the signs and symptoms of the mental health. So we need to educate everyone or all the public regarding the psychological first aid. Who can take the first aid? Everyone. Either the family members, doctors, physicians, even the religious group, community members, resource person, human resources, especially in the workplace, you need to educate them. Even though they have the productivity, they will be discriminated or stigmatized. It should be reduced. Okay? And for the community group, even for the frontline workers, they have to be educated with the mental health first aid. What you are supposed to do. Then we all know that what is a first aid kit. We all know that we have the bandages, we have the scissor, we have the torch, everything we have for the first aid, we all know. But these are the things which I want to add in this psychological first aid kit. First one is provide safety and security. So when the person is trying to kill himself or herself, when person is injurious or the person is harmful to others, first you need to think about the safety. Safety comes first. And security. How secure you are. When the person is violent in the ward, you are working there as a psychiatric nurse. It's your responsibility to make the patient to calm down. लेकिन ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है ना, जब patient violent हो रहा है तो वहीं पर जाके आपको बात करनी है, right? So you should know that when and how you are going to approach to the people who are violent, aggressive, and people who are in the suicidal, just to save the security and safety of that individual. Second one is convey the acceptance. The one principles of the mental health nurse or the mental health, we say that accept the patient as he is, right? So what we do is, whatever the patient is, you have to accept the patient as he is. Whether the patient is showing the bizarre behavior, disorganized speech, any like unacceptable behavior patient is showing, still you have to accept that. He is like that only. So you have to care him based on that. Don't just exclude the patient like that, he is behaving in that way. Okay? And you have to encourage the self-help. You might have seen about the schizophrenic group they have and the alcoholic group they have, the Alcohol Anonymous. Likewise, the people who are in that chronic illness, when they recover from that, they can make a group. So that each one of them, it becomes a support system for them. One of them will come and speak about it, how they have suffered and how they have been coming across all these difficulties in the society. And express empathy. As we all know that when someone comes to you, we just sympathize them. कोई बात नहीं, सबके साथ ऐसे होता है, तुम्हें भी ऐसा हो गया, थोड़ी देर बाद सब ठीक हो जाए. And when you empathize, you really put yourself to that person's place. The person who is suffering now, the person who is hearing the voices, and they are coming, and saying that मुझे आवाज़ें बहुत सुनाई दे रही, बहुत disturb हो रहा है मुझे, मुझे यहाँ नहीं रहना. When you put yourself in that person's place, you will be able to feel that what are the difficulty the patient is going through now, right? When we don't put ourselves in someone's place, only sympathizing. Yeah, कुछ नहीं होता, सब ठीक हो जाएगा. It's not going to work on your mental health. You need to sympathize, try to understand the condition of the patient, try to understand the feeling of those patients who has come to you for their help. Okay? And that you have to provide the support. As I said now, listen, non-judgmental. We all human beings, right? We usually just the persons on the first side. Yeah, वो तो ऐसा है तो ऐसा ही होगा. Why you are judging one person? Especially when it comes to the mental health, we usually say that listen carefully, be an active listener without judgmental. Don't punish the patient. Don't say this is right, this is wrong. Why you are behaving like this? This is your behavior is not acceptable. You are not supposed to show this in front of us. You don't have the right to judge anyone's behavior, especially in the field of mental health. Okay? And next one is, what are the skills which required for this giving the psychological first aid? First one, as I said, How will you identify the signs and symptoms of mental disorders? And what are the, you should have the knowledge about what are the risk factors. For example, as I said, in the genetically or the biological factors, some of the people in the family are suffering from the mental ill. And if you know that, there may be the chances. And even for the schizophrenic, there is a 20% chances of getting in that siblings. Okay, if you know that, you can advise the people. You can make the persons to practice the good mental hygiene so that at least it can be prevented. Or some counseling session, it can be done. Okay, so this has to be done. And you should make the awareness about the medical such. What are the facilities available now? PGT is available. Many psychotherapies are available. Play therapy for the adolescents. Many group therapies are available. That you should be aware about it before you give the psychological first aid. Okay, so that how you are going to initiate the help? You want to help someone, so you just see that you go to help karne aayo, to aap aage aa jao. You cannot say in that way, right? You should understand who is that person and what the problem is. Then only you can start the initiation of the help and support. When to take the appropriate action? As I said now, when person comes and talks to you regarding the suicidal ideation or suicidal thought, if you don't take up the action appropriately at the correct time, one person's life will be lost. As I said, suicide is a preventable death and premature death. If you take the action appropriate time, correct timing, then life can be saved. So in that stress, trauma, when you are going to take the appropriate action. So this is the action plan of the first aid. How you are going to do? First one is, you have to prepare yourself. As I said now, you have to prepare yourself about the crisis event. Crisis event in the sense like accident, the person who is harming the self or the others, or who has the risk to harm the other people. Now you have to see that, what is the severity of this event? What is happening with an individual? Okay? And you have to learn about the, what are the support system of that person, whether the family members are supportive, whether the friends are supportive, what is the support system of that individual? You need to prepare at that first, and what are the services available in the nearby? Okay? And you have to learn about the safety and security concern. As I told you now, you are there to help them out, but the security for you and patient is very important. So after preparing, now you have to look. What you are supposed to look? Safety of that person and yours. And the, what is the urgent basic need based on the priority. Okay? So the, when the person comes, like when the person comes in the, otherwise in the earthquake and all, in one this crisis situation, when the, many people are there, you should know that who needs the more attention. First, and this one is the serious distress reaction. This you have to look after that, and next you have to listen to them. What you are going to listen? Who may need the help immediately? Whom you are going to give the help? And what is the need and concern of that people? What exactly the need? And what help they feel calm? And then now you have to link with this. Now you will be understanding that who needs that and what need it, what help they need. So you will be transferring those people to the, transferring people around to the mental health professionals. Okay? So that is the, you have to give the information. Information in the sense like, if you don't know, don't tell anything. If you know, then you speak it up. Okay? Because if you give the wrong or the negative information, it may become more harm to the patient. So be careful before you act. And here also same thing in by Australian Mental Health First Aid International Group has given that. That is in the form of the ALGI. ALGI is nothing but first one is the approach. How are you going to approach them? When you approach the patient, directly don't just ask them, I'm going to help you or what problem do you have? So let the person say, I have this problem, I want to talk about you regarding this. Okay? And you have to assess that, what is the severity and how can you assist with that? How are you going to help them? And listen, as I said, non-judgmentally, you have to give the support and information, encourage the appropriate professional help, and encourage other support people. We know that good communication skill is very important. what are you going to say and do? Okay, first one is you should find a place where you can work, you can talk, both of you, to be safe side, to maintain the privacy and confidentiality. And when someone is saying and talking with you, you just feel like active listening doesn't mean that you just keep quiet and listen. You should be nodding your head, indicating that okay, I'm listening to you, you can carry on. Okay? And that you have to be very honest to the people. If you don't know and if you don't have the answer, you just say that, okay, I don't know now, I'll try to find out, I'll come back to you. But in that, some of the information is like I told you, first, try to find out what is the understanding level of the person. You'll be explaining many things about this, these are the services available here, there, online and all. When a person doesn't know anything, it's of no use. Okay? And respect the privacy. And here are the things, what not to say. We human beings, हमारी ये आदत होती है ना कहानी सुनने का या स्टोरी सुनने का, उसके बाद क्या हुआ, हमारे साथ ऐसा कैसे हुआ, आगे बताओ, ये बताओ. We all say that, right? But this has to be avoided, okay? And don't interrupt about someone's story, okay? And you have to, don't give your opinion. Yeah, अगर तू अपने साथ ऐसा हो रहा है तो it's maybe like this. Don't just give your opinion. And if there is no acceptability, then don't touch the patient. Especially for the psychiatric patient or the schizophrenic, you are not supposed to touch the patient. And you are not going to judge. Why you are feeling in that way? सबके साथ ऐसा होता है. So don't feel in that way. You don't have the right to say that. Whatever the patient is feeling, it's right from their side, not from your side. Okay? So don't use the technical terms. Don't give the false reassurance. As we all know that reassuring the patient is very important. When you are working in that psychiatric clinical area, patient will come and tell you what to do. मेरा तो ये problem है. कोई बात नहीं, दवाई ले लो, ठीक हो जाएगा, जल्दी डिस्चार्ज हो जाएंगे. इज इट रियली हैपनिंग फॉर द मेंटल इल पेशेंट? नो. सो यू आर गिविंग द फॉल्स रीअश्योरेंस. सो डोंट रीअश्योर द पेशेंट, इट विल बिकम मोर हार्म. द पेशेंट्स इन द क्लिनिकल एरिया विल बी बिहाइंड यू, मुझे डिस्चार्ज करा दो, छुट्टी करा लो, छुट्टी करा लो. ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट, इफ यू आर सेइंग कोई बात नहीं, दवाई ले लो, डिस्चार्ज हो जाएगा, हाउ गोइंग टू वर्क आउट? ओके, सो don't give that false reassurance. So in that, the discrimination, dignity and stigma can be removed, or this, it can be done with the collaboration, like from the patient itself, from the family member, from the government policy makers. Recently, we had a public lecture on this topic, and the person from the additional secretary from the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, he was present there, and he has said that one new policy has come up in India. The people who are suffering with the mentally ill, they will be covered up as an insurance. Before, they were not covered. Cardio, then other disorders and cancer were only insurance covered. But now this is a new bill who has been passed in the Lok Sabha, and this bill will be coming up soon. So now they will be claiming, they can claim. Okay? And the special sector of the NGO, I just want to quote here one thing, like in Goa, one NGO named is Sangat, and they are doing some approach that is Sundar. Sundar is in Vishay, it is very beautiful. So what they do is, they educate the people, or they make the people aware about the mental health. So in the lay people or the public, they give the training. Okay? How they give the training is, they give the training based on the information who has been evidence based. It has been found out that it is that. Okay, so this is how that with the interaction from all the section, we can reduce the discrimination. So lastly, I just want to say that psychological first aid is not something that only professional can do. If you train the people around, they also can have the capability to train the people how to diagnose the mentally ill. It's not a professional counseling, it's not counseling. And it's not a psychological debriefing, like you are not going to discuss anything about what had happened to the patient, okay? You are not going to analyze anything about the incident. And what intervention, as I said, that mental and the physical health parity. This is a very important one. We all know that physical health, whenever you have any headache, abdomen pain, you go to the physician. Okay, but in the mental health, nobody comes. So you should make the people to aware that mental health illness is also like the physical illness. So the general practitioners will play a very important role here. People who come to them, they have been able to diagnose that, then they have to give the referral services to them.